This is a good area, being the county seat. So, what else, Reverend?
Well, we also are going to have a panel discussion, and this panel will feature a number of experts dealing with various issues, and Regina will talk more about that.
Right. Our panel is actually encompassing all three of the hospitals, well, the main three hospitals, Abington, Mercy Suburban, and Einstein Montgomery. They're sending us health professionals, and they're going to speak, each of them, for about 5 to 10 minutes, and they're going to speak on Alzheimer's, breast, prostate, and testicular cancer, hospice care, nutrition, including carbohydrates in your diet, obesity, healthy eating, how to incorporate that into our fast lifestyles. You know, that's very important because so many people eat out anymore. So they're going to talk about things like that, make it a, you know, everyday application, things that we can do. They're going to talk about maternity and children's health, nutrition, again, and pain. Aside of doing the panel discussion, they'll also be at tables so that people can come and talk to them individually, and they'll all have information to provide to people.
Well, you mentioned one other thing here, Alzheimer's, right?
Yes.
Well, I've had cancer, this, that, and everything, but my wife has Alzheimer's, okay? Last 5 years. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it's, thank God she's happy and everything, but I have to have somebody there in the morning, take care of her, then somebody in the afternoon, so I can, you know, are able to do what I do today.
Right.
So I know what it is, so important.
Right.
In fact, next week I'm going to have Dr. Verghese, who is an expert on Alzheimer's. That'd be good to have come to your church.
Absolutely.
Right.
Fantastic.
Okay.
He was very helpful with my wife when she was first, you know, got it, like. In the beginning, I didn't realize what was going on.
Right, most people don't.
When I was a policeman, I'd go here, go there. She'd pick up the phone and answer, you know. And I would be away maybe weeks at a time at a conference or something. And then one day, I get a call from the police department, ambulance, and tell me that your wife is here. She don't know how to get back home, you know.
Right.
So, you know, and then it's just one thing after another, one thing after another. So now I have to have someone there. As a nurse, retired nurse, mm-hmm. and have to pay. Mm-hmm. But then I got the family services that mm-hmm. helps out in the afternoon as like a partners and all. Mm-hmm. So I want people to be aware, to
right.
be ready. And I would say that I think they ought to have a course in school to start teaching kids how to change diapers for
That's
adults.
Right. That's right.
And not
right.
only just for little babies, but the time comes, you know, when I was first married, I have three daughters. Okay, a stepson, but I never changed a diaper. My father never changed a diaper. Mm-hmm. My mother had 8 children, never mm-hmm. changed. I never,
mm-hmm. right.
no, I never changed it. But now, mm-hmm. it's a whole different ball
sure.
game. So,
it
you
is.
Know, it's a love. You know, Philadelphia Inquirer did a story on us. You know, the lady came here and spent 5 hours and to see how I live and how mm-hmm. I talk and how
okay.
we do.
Mm-hmm.
And it was something, you know, but I want anybody can get it. They don't know when it's going to start, where it's going to end.
Yeah.
You know,
right?
But
yeah.
you would never know.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know. So, like I say, now what you're doing here, is very important. People can walk around and something. They might have something that don't realize that they would start some kind of treatment now before it gets out of hand.
Right.
Right.
You can elaborate on that.
Yes, they can, and you made a very good point because there's also resources out there that help caregivers because, as you mentioned, so many more people now are taking care of their loved ones at home. So there's
right.
resources and support groups out there for caregivers, and we actually have Representative Matt Bradford coming, mm-hmm. and he's going to be having information.
What's available for the state.
Exactly. What's available as far as community resources.
I'd like to have some of that stuff available.
Right,
I don't know.
So anything like related to health care, to getting housing, to getting medical coverage, aging and adult services, children's services,
right.
anything that would fall under community resources, Representative Matt Bradford will be there and have all that information
for people.
That's good.
That's very good. Well, not only that, you're helping physically, but also financially too.
Yes.
Because
yes.
I have to pay for this or that, pay for that, and they say, well, I only live on a pension. I don't
right.
I don't have a side job or anything.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to pay for diapers, this, that, and the other thing, you know. But mm-hmm. maybe there's stuff out there that that I'm right, I that can people get that aren't I don't, aware, I'm not aware of.
Exactly, and that's what we want to try to get that information to people. Like you said, to let them know what services are available. Right. We also are going to have people, you talk about finances, we hope to have people there that are going to talk about finances, banking, investments, to try to help people with their financial, you know, just kind of guide them if necessary.
You know, I have three daughters, and they all, one comes to help out one day, the other day, there. They all, one takes care of the finances, you know. So I'm going to ask them to go to that and to get some information, you know.
Yes.
So I'm no high muckety muck. I could use as much help as anybody else out there. You know, I spent 24 years with the police department, another 13 with county detectives, did all these things. But now time comes that I have to look and see where I can get help.
Right.
And I'm no big deal, no high muckety muck guy. I'm just a regular guy. Mm-hmm. So I want you to be aware and to know where to get the information. That's what it's all about. And it's out there. You just have to, you know, ask some questions. Reverend, hit it again.
Well, one of the last things I want to highlight, Hank, is that we really need to appeal to the community to come out and to support this event. A lot of work has gone into it. I think you'll see that the lineup of doctors and screens are top-notch. We want to encourage and appeal to everyone in the greater Norristown area to come and to support this event on May 4th. We know May 4th is a very busy day.
Yeah,
but
you can have the, what do you call it, festival,
the Arts Festival.
But you can get checked out and then get down to the Art Hill or go to the Art Hill and go over there, whatever
exactly.
way.
Exactly.
Visit both.
Exactly right. As we said, you can come, have a few screens, and then leave or come for the panel discussion or to hear Ms. Shepherd speak and then leave. But we want to appeal to the community, the entire community, religious, non-religious, because even though this is sponsored by churches, this event is for the entire community.
Well, what's the difference? Who's the sponsor? You sponsor the church. What's
That's
the difference?
Right.
It was the bingo sponsor.
There
it,
you
know?
Go. There
or the casino
go.
Or whatever.
That's right.
Right.
It's just the idea to help pick up the expenses, and that's more important than anything.
That's right.
And as you said,
and what's wrong with religion?
Right. And as you
got
said,
a problem with it?
Pastor West will be there. My pastor, Pastor Dorian Stevenson Sr. from Christian Community will be there. Bishop Luis Mendez from the Fountain of Living Waters will be there. So, you know, we'll have our celebrities there.
Well, they are celebrities.
They are celebrities.
They're
yes.
my heroes.
That's right.
It's
That's
a song
right.
about heroes. Hero. I don't know.
If I told you, you might ask me
you
to
know?
Sing.
You know any song like that?
If I answered that, you'd ask me to sing.
All right, go ahead. What?
Oh, and I didn't want to forget a couple things too. We're going to have someone there to talk about VA benefits, which are so important nowadays.
That's important.
Yeah. So we'll have people there talk about that. As like I said, from Mercy Suburban, they're going to have people to talk about smoke cessation and respiratory health, sickle cell disease, domestic
about smoking,
smoke cessation, how to stop smoking. People that will, we'll have someone from chiropractic medicine there. And health insurance and benefits, which is a big thing now.
Tell me about
a lot of people don't have health insurance because of the job situations. So there will be people there to give information on how to acquire that also.
You know, it's so important to go there and to get this information, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, how long you been a reverend, minister?
Well, I've been at Siloam Baptist Church for almost 20 years coming this
Here
October.
In Norristown?
In Norristown.
How come you haven't been on the show?
I don't know. You haven't invited me.
That's an idea. All right. You're here now.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, I remember when, like I said, I mentioned earlier, that Reverend Allen, you know, mm-hmm. really way back, I think he lived on the corner of
Willow
Spruce,
and Wood.
Willow and Spruce, I think
okay.
is right on the corner there.
Yes.
I remember, yeah.
Yes.
So, now, and you're originally from New Jersey.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
What inspired you? What dropped the seed for you to become a minister?
Well, I grew up in a Christian family.
Oh,
my parents were very much involved in the church. like many young people, I had my season where I left the confines of the church and went out and explored the world, as one might say. And
what do you mean explore? What'd you do?
Well, I don't want to get arrested, so I can't go into great detail about that. But we did some things, let's say, that the Bible says you should not do.
Well, remember, all sunshine makes deserts. You want a beautiful garden, you have to have rain, snow, hail, and everything that goes with it, right?
Right.
So, and how about you? What caused you to be a nurse? What dropped the seed?
I think the biggest thing is that I've always had a love of taking care of people. I remember as a young teenager, when I was in school, and people would say, what do you want to do with your life? And I said, I don't know what I want to do. And they said, well, what do you like to do? And I said, well, I like taking care of people. And I was probably about 13 at the time, so it never dawned on me to go in that I wanted to be a nurse. But right. That is something, that is what, just caring for people is what made me decide good. To
well,
be a nurse.
Well, that was good, good. I guess the same thing with me with being a policeman. My mom always said, do good and the people move you forward. You know, always help. Like I've been in an accident, driving along, I see an accident, I would stop to help, you know. So it was just in my brothers, my sisters and all, you know. But, well, our half hour is over.
Okay.
Just want you to give you a couple minutes on what you, about May the 4th.
May the
4th. From 10 a.m.
Great
till 3.
Day. Till 3 o'clock.
What are we going to have here at the Carver Center?
At the Carver
Jacobian
Center.
Jacobian Arch.
We're going to have the Seasons of Life Health Fair. And it's going to be one of the best health fairs Norristown has ever seen. And it's going to be an opportunity for the community to learn more about how they can live healthy and whole lives.
Right.
And at 10:15 in the morning, we're actually going to have gospel Zumba dancing. So if people want to come and get a little activity, cardiovascular going, you know, that's going to be at 10:15. So that's a good way of getting some exercise. And we're going to show people how to do exercise in a fun way.
Oh, my God. Well, all right. Thank you for coming here. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks a lot for allowing us to come into your home. And I think this is so important to be able to check your health. And be healthy, and you know, and how should I say it? You know, God put us on this earth to enjoy life, and so enjoy it. And like I say, if you have a little bit of a problem, when in doubt, check it out. So until we meet again, in boxing they say bob and weave, and Lawrence Welk says keep a song in your heart. Hank Cisco says check with your heart doctor. Okay, so till we meet again. Keep bobbing and weaving, and may God bless each and every one of you. God bless.